Hello, everyone. I'm Ariel with Urbanist, and welcome to Paris, France, one of the most beautiful cities in the entire world. And we're going to one of the most beautiful churches in this city of lights, Saint-Sulpice. I'm Ariel. This is Urbanist. This is a show where we explore cities all around the world. I showed this via Facebook Live, but I'm going to give you a 360 video perspective because there's some amazing murals, organs, a bunch of details all in this church. Saint-Sulpice is most recently famous for being the where all the answers culminate at the end of the Da Vinci Code, written by Dan Brown and later adapted into a film directed by Ron Howard and starring Tom Hanks. Here we have a bunch of pigeons outside. Now, if we look at the outside, it looks a lot like St. Paul's Cathedral in London. And that's because much of the design is based on St. Paul's. Highlights of Saint-Sulpice is three murals made by one of the most famous painters of the early 1900s, Eugène Delacroix, right here. Two organs. This is the great organ, which we see above, one of the largest organs in the entire city. And then a little bit further down, we're going to see the choir organ. Here towards the side, you'll see that there is some burn damage. In March 2019, a fire broke loose in Saint-Sulpice, just a mere few weeks or months before the great fire of Notre Dame, and the marks were left in a few of the main areas. However, they end up finding out that the fire that was started in March 2019 was intentional. Arson. Why? I don't know. However, the main mystery of this church is that obelisk right over there. That obelisk is the centerpiece of Dan Brown's Da Vinci Code. It's a purely work of fiction, but the obelisk is real. It was installed here in the late 1700s as a science experiment in order to calculate the sun. It's called a gnomon. Let's take a closer look. So here is the Gnomon Astronomicus. This, contrary to what was depicted in the Da Vinci Code, is not part of the priority of Sion, the secret order of priests in the Roman Catholic Church. This was made for a science experiment. And it's basically like a huge sundial, except it functions slightly differently. There's a beam of light that comes through the window with a lens that's attached in one of the stained glasses, shines right here, and then leads a shadow that tells you exactly how high the sun is. And after many calculations, you can kind of calculate how the sun is traveling in the sky. However, when they built this Gnomon Astronomicus and made it so beautiful with the obelisk and the little ball on top, and it's gorgeous as well, beautiful engraving, the lens over there was not well made. It was a poorly made lens, did not work as intended, so this science experiment never worked. Or, if you're a fan of Da Vinci Code, did it not work? Maybe that's what they want you to know. Of course, Da Vinci Code is fiction. Look at the gorgeous stonework. It took 200 years to build this church. There's no surprise why. Let's take a look at one of the chapels. Here's a little exhibition about all the murals in the chapel. I think this church really sticks out because of all the beautiful murals painted by a bunch of different artists, Eugene Delacroix just being one of them. Right inside here is a confession booth. Here you sit down or kneel down, usually kneeling, and you talk to the priest, which is behind the screen, and you tell him all your sins. And after you tell him all your sins, always blesses you and gives you a set amount of prayers to say. And that's in the Roman Catholic tradition, though I think also extends to a few other traditional Christian traditions. smaller chapels all around us. Now let me show you the choir organ, which is right here. Let's actually go right here. Maybe this one. Here is some holy water, which the other churches and chapels can come and grab some for their own services. So here we have a really interesting depiction of death. The depiction of death is not the only one here in Paris. There's a few different death statues and depictions of the angel of death. One of them being the Pantheon and another one being in the University of Medicine. Here we have Jesus Christ on Mary's arms, Mary being his mother, and on the side, Mary Magdalene, which is very pivotal to the story of the Da Vinci Code. And two angels beside him. One of them carrying the crown of thorns, which apparently is in Notre Dame. However, whether that's legend or not, no one knows. Yourself. There we go. That was Sun Soupis here in the neighborhood of Saint-Germain-des-Prés in Paris, France. Saint-Germain-des-Prés, the neighborhood, has another very iconic church. That one being the oldest of the city. However, I think both of them are awesome to check out. I hope you enjoyed this 360 tour. Saw all the different angles. If you are watching this a month before it's released publicly as a supporter, thank you so much for lending your support. If you want to become a supporter, you can click that link below. If you're watching afterwards, thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed this beautiful church. I've been meaning to film this in 360 for the longest time. It's so gorgeous. It's mesmerizing. No wonder Dan Brown used it as his centerpiece for the Da Vinci Code. It feels like a church filled with mysteries. But also, this is really good-looking, very interesting-looking church. In the film, they actually didn't film here. Ron Howard, the director, asked for permission. However, the Diocese of Paris rejected him, mostly because they didn't like the associations of occult and Illuminati references associated with the church. So, nonetheless, it's a gorgeous church to visit. Thank you so much for tuning in. Keep being awesome, and always keep on exploring. Have a great day, everyone.